We're here with Kelley Carlton, a man of many talents. First of all, you're a paramedic, EMT, correct?
Yes, sir.
All right. Now, today we're at MODOC Speedway for the MODOC 100, 11th annual MODOC 100, and you're the race director for this show tonight.
Yes, sir. I've been involved with the Cushman family for quite some time. They've always been very good to me, and they needed some help. You know, they do a special events only type program or season, so we try to help them out every opportunity we get.
All right. Well, now that you brought that up, what are some of the next dates coming up?
Well, they have a few more shows. They're actually doing a local show type thing coming up at the end of the month on the 30th. And then we have a super late model show here that will be the ultimate super late models for the Jack Storette race coming up in May. And, they have a new website that they just put up this week, modocraceway.com, that has the complete schedule for this year on it. Real nice job. So any questions about the racetrack or the schedule certainly can be found there.
All right, now you brought it up, the ultimate super late models. You're also the race director there.
Yeah, series director for the ultimates. This is my eighth year, their ninth season, and my eighth year doing it. And we've already had one event back in North Georgia last week. Had a real good week, and we have a good season planned this year. You know, all our sponsors are back for the year, so pretty excited about where we're going and what we have in the future, and you know, our new regions and things that we've established. So I think we have a pretty bright future ahead.
Yeah, the Ultimate Series has really expanded in the last 2-3 years, hasn't it?
It has. You know, we started out with the Battle of the Bluegrass, and we've actually rebranded that this year to make it the Heart of America, and then just kind of changing the territory a little bit. And then our Ultimate Deep South is going to be starting up this year, kind of that Texas, Mississippi, Louisiana area. And, we already had the Northeast is really strong with Rose and Jeff Compton up there. They've done a really good job, and I know they're going to have another big year. And then Robbie Cyrus over at the Mid-Ohio Valley Ultimate stuff, you know, they've done a real good job. I think he has about 12 or 14 races. So it's kind of networking out and really, the biggest thing is we try to do everything the same in all the regions to help racers kind of have that continuity.
All right. Well, that is really cool. I'm sure Stan Lester's happy about that. But now let's go back to, the last thing you're doing, I guess you could say, for the interview anyway, we're going to talk about SCDRA.
Right. Yeah, SCDRA is a Sport Compact Dirt Racing Association. It actually was born at Screbin Motor Speedway, 10 years ago now. Reds started out having this big front-wheel drive race that paid $5,000 to win. And he said, I'm going to up at $1,000 to win every year. And so he asked us to come and help him with it. And we started helping, and you know, I really actually fell in love with the racers. And you know, these guys are such a family type knit group that it really, really drew me to it. And then a lot of the racers kept saying, hey, man, let's do a series. We can put a series together. We'd follow you wherever you go. And, man, they have. They've been really loyal and followed us everywhere. So we started the deal, and we do about 8 or 10 races a year. This race tonight is not actually a SCDRA-sanctioned event, but it is using our rule set. And we have some of those guys that are here from Florida. One of the guys from Ohio is here. You know, they come for $1,000 to win. And just a really great group of guys, and I'm proud to be associated with them. One of the neat things the racetrack here tells me, they love having them come here because they've never seen a group of racers that cleaned up after themselves like these guys do. They don't leave anything behind. And
they can't afford to.
Right, yeah, that's true. Really great group of guys, and I'm really, like I said, I'm really proud to be involved with them. And it's really neat, you know, we added some racetracks in Mississippi are going to start using our rules. A lot of the racetracks up in the north we're already using. So it's kind of spreading out. And my goal in the whole thing was to make it where a guy that has a front-wheel drive car would be able to jump in his front-wheel drive, take his family on vacation, take his race car with him, and race wherever he went in the country. Sort of how it is with our late model division. So that was kind of
uniformed rules.
Right. Kind of the thought was to get that uniform rule and make it easier for tech men to be able to tech rule, because I mean, you know, the front wheel drive cars, you know, Honda has about 20 engines alone. Yeah. That these guys can use. So we just tried to make it a little easier for tech men, you know, the important things. And it's really taken off, and you know, I could probably do 10 more races if I had the time, but we really just don't have the time to get that many in.
Well, let's see, you have a real job. You do PR or race directing at MODOK, race director for Ultimate, and are you the series owner or race director there for this CDRA?
I own it and do the race direction and PR and sweep and whatever has to be done.
When do you sleep?
When I get a chance. You left out, I do also race direct at Scriven, but.
Oh, yes, I forgot about that.
That's, but it's only a 5 or 6 race schedule, so.
And how many races does MODOK have a year, about 10?
Well, no, they're going to be about the 6 to 7 range again this year, just kind of maybe once a month or so in the warmer months, that kind of thing. Mr. Cushman, Ms. Cushman, you know, they have Cushman Paint and Body, and it's a really large business that they have to keep up with, but they love this racetrack, and man, they poured a lot of money into it. And if you were here last year, you can come and see how much difference they've made. They've added a whole new surface, and they changed the configuration, redid the concession stands. I mean, they just continually spend money and make the place better and better and better.
Are you got any sponsors or anything from Kelcar Motorsports you want to?
Well, yeah, you know, Arizona Sports Shirts has always been very good to us, and they take care of us, you know, provide us with all our uniform shirts, and can't thank them enough. Got a race. Big Ace Custom Graphics does all our checks, and, you know, anything that we need decal-wise, they take care of. We have a couple of guys that are really good about helping us. Jason Waters Tuning always steps up and sponsors the events. Also, we've had, you know, just innumerate guys that race that have businesses too, they'll step up and sponsor a fast time or something like that at the show. So all those guys that chip in, I really appreciate that. And I know it all goes back to the racers. That's the biggest thing.
Well, we want to thank Kelley Carlton for chatting with us here for a little while tonight while we're at MODOK. And I hope you get some sleep, and I hope everything works out for you in 2019.
All right, Richard. Thanks for having us, buddy.